Hello everybody and welcome back to New Riador. Today I thought we might start in a different place than usual, because I'm right now here at the Enderman farm doing a bit of enchanting, because as you know, in the last episode I broke my helmet. So it was broken by the silverfish. So I was here doing some enchanting in the meantime. And I already repaired my shoes because they were almost broken too. And now I'm working on getting a new helmet, and what I've got so far is this Blast Protection Aqua Affinity Respiration, which is not bad but also not good, an Aqua Affinity and a Protection 4 helmet. And I also have some books here, so this one is looting, and these two are unbreaking. And the next one that I can get will be a Protection 4 book. So I thought we can do that on camera now, so I would try now to put Protection 4 on this one. Ah, it still keeps the blast protection. Ah, what a bummer. Yeah, so that's not possible, so I guess we'll stick with the blast protection for this one, but of course I want to have unbreaking on that one, and it should be named Aquaria, cause that's my aqua helmet. So at least we've got the respiration and aqua affinity now back. It was quite annoying to not be able to dive underwater and swim there. So now that that's back, that's good. So let's see where the end portal actually takes me, because I have no clue where we will end up now. So let's skip this. And as it seems, we are at Sven's and Lena's place, cause I was here in between the episodes doing some stuff. You might see in their episodes quite soon, I don't know. But let me head back to the base and then we can continue over there. So I'm back at the base, and the plans for today are quite easy to tell, because last time we did this temple over there, and that still needs the endermites, and we need to free the silverfish from the stone blocks and name them all. You had a lot of suggestions in the comments, which I have plenty of to pick from, and we can do that a bit later. But first up, I want to do something else, because I want to try to get a villager that sells name tags, because it's really a pain to get those by fishing. We've got the automatic fishing thing over there, and it really takes forever to get name tags like this. And we've got this villager set up over here where they can breed already, so we should try to get some of them. We'll just make a basic sorter where we can say, okay, I want this one or I don't want this one. So we can sort out the librarians and try to get one that will sell us name tags. And while this will be then in the breeding mode, I can really get some doors already. I might be working a little bit more on the temple, because you guys really wanted me to put some sand around it. And that's something that I would definitely do. Also, the idea was putting fences up top where you can go to the upper level. You guys really liked, and you said that that would add a lot to the, let me see, six doors, to the actual temple. It would make it feel more, more like an attraction, I would say. So I will do that, and then there were also some other cool comments, like a suggestion that I really liked for the aquarium, and I will add that name later to the temple, I think. But for now, let me add these doors in. So we just need the six doors to activate the breeder again, and then we can go down maybe. I can't hop over this fence, break it. And then these guys will repopulate, and we can sort out the babies by opening up these. Oh, you can see the hearts already. So the babies will fall down into here, and then they can be stored here for now, and we can take a look at them and sort out the ones that we don't like. We'll find a way of how to sort them, but As soon as these are open, as you can see, there's glass on top, so the adults can't go down, but the babies can. And I will leave this running for a while since we need 20 minutes at least. Oh, there's already one. But you're not a librarian. We need at least 20 minutes to let them grow up, to see their traits. And I also got plenty of emeralds from trading with Skid, because he needed a bunch of iron, so I once gave him 9 stacks of iron blocks and he gave me 1 stack of emerald blocks, which makes 9 stacks of emeralds. Should be plenty for now. And yeah, I think that I would just keep on doing that things here, and then I will see you in a bit when we can do some further progress with these villagers, and maybe I did something with the temple already. Aren't these guys cute? Of course we'll have to wait until they grow up, but we've got quite a bunch of them in here now. We can take these two librarians back there, maybe bring them out and see if we can trade with them. But in the meantime, I did some work at the temple. Oh, the silence here, that's nice. I placed a bunch of sand around, almost used up all of our reserves on sand. And I think it turned out quite nice. It's like a mini biome in the jungle here. Let's see if I can make the jump. Over here, of course I can. So yeah, I just used the normal terrain how it was before and placed sand around and some cacti. Maybe we'll place some dead bushes too. And then upstairs you can see I placed the fences. So let's check that out. I can just hop in from here. So if you come up, you have the fence also to this side, so visitors can't go on top of the pyramid. And then we can be here on top of our cells. Down there we still have the silverfish blocks to then later on name some of the silverfish. And yeah, now I think I would just have to wait until these guys grow up so we can do something with them. And then we'll trade a bit. While we are waiting, let's do some breeding. So we've got our horses here, and I think that I want to breed Passat with Ibiza again and see if we can maybe get a better offspring. So let's check this out. I've got a saddle, I've got sugar. Where is it? Over here. Let's see, of course, this one comes out. Perfect. So you stay inside, please. I should just hop off here and then go around. Why is it going to this horse here? That's weird. Okay, let's grow him up. We still have the bug that it looks big, but it's actually not. I can't ride it just yet. Let's feed it around half a stack of sugar. Then I think it instantly kicks off still, so some more sugar for him. There we go. And already tamed, so I can put the saddle on and we can test this guy. Feels not bad from the speed, so let's measure it. And it has a speed of 10.5 blocks, so that's good. And then jump height is, I would say, something around here. Nope, lower. Yep, can do that one. So that was 3.0. Oh, that was a bad jump. Yeah, 3.0 and 10.5 blocks, so we can put another sign down. Over here has no name yet. 10.5 like this, 3.0 and 12 hearts. So let me put him in here, take the saddle off, and we've got another horse. Okay, let's try to get this one into a minecart. I brought some rails with me and of course a minecart, and I hope that I can get him in. Maybe. Possibly. Ah, come on. Not me. Let's break this again and try it once more. There we go. Got him. Okay, now we can close this off and then we can try and see if we can unlock some nice trades with this guy, so we can actually then get name tags. So let's see what you've got so far. Projectile protection and paper. I think that I will have to buy this one to get a new trade, because I don't have any paper in the base. So I will get around to get some materials, or maybe we can transport him actually to the tower. We'll see, but I think it's easier to get the materials to here. Let's hope the best that this is working, because that's quite a lot of emeralds and I don't want this book at all. But we'll see if he unlocks a new trade. I really hope so. He's blinking at least. 10 books for an emerald, we can do that. Let's see what's next. 11 emeralds for a compass. Oh, we've got more trades. 4 emeralds for a bookshelf. 2 written books for an emerald. 10 emeralds for a clock. 1 emerald for glass. Let us actually buy the glass, because that's just 1 emerald. And next, I should actually turn down the volume of the friendly creatures, so it's less annoying for you guys. No, we don't want that one. Let's buy one more glass. And I don't know how it works now. I haven't done trading in 1.8 yet, I think. But it seems that he unlocked a new trade once more. Fire protection this time. Okay. More glass. If I have problems with this, I can always just ask then Skid, because he knows everything about the strain. I think this time nothing happened. So one more emerald, more glass. It's actually nice, because glass is actually useful, so we're not wasting that much. Okay, name tag. There we go. That was what I was looking for. So we've got a name tag guy. I wanna quickly hop into the wiki and take a look if that's expensive or cheap. And it turns out this is actually the most expensive it can be, but I don't care, because it's in between 20 and 22, so maybe it will get cheaper over time. But for now, let's see how many we want to buy. So we need quite a lot of name tags. And maybe we will set up something where we can easily get the emeralds then. Maybe we also need then an automatic farm for carrots and stuff, because I think that's the way to go now. It's not sugarcane anymore. But maybe we go with the paper stings. So let's see. 2. Do I get more? 4. 5. I know that he will block it at some point. Like now, it's blocked. And we might have to do something else. Let's see what he does. Oh, the trade is not locked. So let's see how many we can get this time. We are at 14, 16, nice. And he's changing again. Still the same trade here, and I'm almost out of emeralds. I guess I will spend them all now. I don't have another use for these emeralds at the moment. And he's blocked again. Changing. And still 22. But yeah, 25 name tags. That's not too bad. I mean, I spent now, I don't know, maybe 3/4 of an hour to get this guy. And we'll just keep him here, just in case we want to trade with him again. As I said in the beginning, I really like the idea of having fish being shot into an aquarium, and that idea was posted by a guy called Don Rosemarine. So as I said, I want to add his name, of course, to the temple, because that's a quite cool thing, spelled like this, I think. So he has now his place in here. Also, in between the clips, I already named the name tags, so I was going through and was choosing a few of the name tags, and of course I want to tell you who suggested that, so let me quickly go through them. I decided to put 12 animals in each of the sides here, And then let's start from the back here. We've got Maggie by Grandolian, then Andy by The Comic Gaming, Tiki by Anton Patterson, Endermite by Sticky's Official, Clicky by Chloe, Mighty by G. W. Jarrett, then Sheldon by Michael Deutkes, Silly by Harley Mars, Sylvia by Enderdude, then Speedy by Mamba LP, Spike by Possum, and Stoned by myself. I really like that name, and so this, of course, is for the Silverfish, and this here for the Endermite, and I guess that I will now try how it works out if I go into there. I need to see if I can figure out a way how to not get damaged by these guys. Over here, I guess it's a torch missing. Let me quickly get a torch before I start in here, because it will be quite dangerous as soon as these guys are roaming around there. So I will get a torch right from here. I remember that it was lagging while doing the time lapse of the temple, so I placed some blocks where they shouldn't be. Okay, let us get in. And so if I just break the blocks here, they will instantly hit me. So maybe I can get away with that if I reach it through the ceiling, but I don't think that I can reach down that far. So let me try to break this block. I don't think it's actually a silverfish. Nope. We can test who of this contains a silverfish. This one, for example. These are fine, so I can mine these two. Because silverfish blocks you can easily mine real quick. This one isn't one. That's one. That's one. That's none. Okay. That's one, but this is none. It's good to mine them right now, because then they are not in the cell here when we are freeing them. Because I don't want to get into here. Oh, I've got an idea. You know what I'm doing? I will get some invisibility potions, because then I can just go into here and they won't harm me because they won't see me. So I will get some potions. I have still some from brewing or trying to brew night vision potions and make an invisibility. So I'll be right back. Haha, look at me. Invisible. So let me go out of this view so we can try. Okay, this one should be a silverfish. Oh, that was weird. Maybe I need to break it with my hand. There we go. That's a silverfish. Where's he going? I guess we will have to free them all before we can actually name them. Otherwise, they will go back into the blocks. So let me just mine these blocks. Need to be careful to not hit them. Oh, how did you see me? Hey, I'm not here. That's weird. He's not supposed to see me. I'm invisible. They're all seeing me. I had such a good plan. Stop that. Don't want to die. Okay. Plans change. Thank you. Well, I think that that went horribly wrong. That's why I sped up the footage then. And it could have been so easy. I mean, take a look at this. I'm just standing on a half slab now and I can do everything I want. So I just need to figure out who's not named, because after looking at the footage, I renamed Sylvia and I killed Sheldon. I guess you saw that I killed Sheldon, but renaming Sylvia was also a accident. But first let me try to heal this guy's a bit up, because I think they took quite a lot of damage by now through my armor and hitting them. Come over, guys. I'm right here. Okay, so this guy doesn't seem to be named, and this one either. This one is Speedy. So this one is Sheldon now. And let's see. I don't want to make a mistake here and waste another name tag. But I think that's fine to name this one Sylvia. And maybe we will have to get some dead bushes again to put them into here, but for now I want to get out of here. So I will just pillar up, break the slab, break the dirt, and cover up this with sandstone in a moment. And then I think that's how we'll do the endermite thing too. So I'll get some enderpearls and we can try to do that. The unnamed silverfish has despawned, but the ones that I named are still here. I went to the tower and got some stuff. And now I covered up the entrances up here with some dirt and I opened up this here. So there's a hole to drop the guys into. And the way I want to do it now is do it one by one. So this will be sped up, of course, because it might take me quite some time to do that. I only have 2 potions left. And it's a bunch of enderpearls that I will have to throw to get 6 endermites to spawn. So enjoy that little clip now. I guess that I've got them all inside. This was way easier than the silverfish. As you see, I then used a trapdoor to make them find a path towards me. And now they have all fallen in without me even going into the cell. So now I can cover this up again. I will just use half slabs because I don't have a block with me. And then we have our 6 endermites in there to look at. So let's quickly remove these blocks and go down to take a look at both of the sides. But really, from the sound, it feels quite right already. This fits well together, both sides here, the silverfish and the endermite. And it's a quite cool thing to have. Yeah, look at this. On this side, you've got the endermite going around there, and on this side, the silverfish. Endermite are quite a lot smaller than the silverfish are. But I think that this was a quite great thing for the zoo, so a quite great project. And hopefully the other mobs will be easier to get than the silverfish. But I think that I'm totally running out of time for today. So if you enjoyed this episode, then feel free to leave a like, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and share this video with your friends. And I hope then to see you in the next video. So until then, have a great day.